But today, the state's Court of Appeals gave Maryland courts the ability to stop foreclosures if the paperwork does not appear to be valid. 11 News reporter Kai Reed joins us now live in the studio. She has details for us. Kai?
Well, Rod, the emergency measure was passed by the Court of Appeals this afternoon. A local economy and real estate expert says it's a move that's good for individual homeowners, but not great for the economy as a whole.
So from the homeowner's perspective, I think it's very good. From the long-term health of the economy, I think it's a negative.
Professor Roger Steger uses developments in the mortgage crisis as a teaching tool for his students at Johns Hopkins Carey School of Business. Today, the latest news came from the state's highest court. The Court of Appeals passed an emergency measure that gives state courts the ability to stop foreclosures if the paperwork is invalid or fraudulent.
We need to hold the banks and the financial institutions responsible. There is no reason they should not have all of their documentation and all of their documentation organized.
But he says that for many homeowners, delaying the foreclosure process is only delaying the inevitable and hurting the economy.
But in most cases, the foreclosure is legitimate. People have, you know, failed to pay their mortgage, are not paying their full mortgage, which basically means it's a phantom supply in the market. It's houses which need to be foreclosed, which need to be sold, which have not yet hit the market, which means the market is not going to reach equilibrium. We're not going to sell all of those homes until they have been foreclosed, they've worked through the bank, REO, real estate owned, and we reach an equilibrium again.
Accusations of lenders using fraudulent foreclosure paperwork are being investigated in Maryland and across the country. The measure, approved by the Court of Appeals, takes effect immediately and gives lenders 30 days to prove that their paperwork is legal.
We are going to see more of this in the short term. And when I define the short term, I mean 6 to 9 months. Eventually, the banks and the financial institutions are going to get their paperwork and their documentation correct, and then the phantom inventory is going to hit the market.
And so the measure provides judges with guidelines. For example, they can hire outside experts to review documents at the lender's expense, but it's still up to the individual judges to decide exactly how to proceed. Live in the studio, Kai Reed, WBAL-TV 11 News.